Alright, so we're out here today fixing a convertible top, and it's going to be a little complex. I did a little bit of homework on it first to find out how these latching mechanisms work. This is a Mercedes 320 CLK, and it has a hydraulic top system. There's a few pumps all around the top that operate all the little latches and whatnot, and the motors and the arms, and moves it around. So, and specifically, this latching pump right here, as you can see, this latching cylinder is not working, and it's leaking oil everywhere. So we're gonna take it out and replace it. So the first step here is we're gonna take off the. I already did it. There's little clips, these things. You just use a little flat blade screwdriver and it comes right off. And then you use the flat blade screwdriver to pry it off in between here and here. You just pry them off both sides. There's a little clip. One clip and pry off. Easy. Next, there's a Torx bolt. Some Torx around here. These guys. So, there's two of them. So yeah, we're going to remove all four of them, and then this latching assembly will come out. Now this hydraulic cylinder has been leaking a lot, and it's kind of, it's kind of leaking everywhere. So, here's our hydraulic lines, and here's our cylinder here. So I'm just going to set this paper towel underneath all of this. While I remove all the stuff on here, and it's already picking up fluid. Next, there's some clips. There's this one and the one on the bottom of here. That's a lot of fluid. Goodness. Yeah, and a locking pin. And there's another one right there. See it? It's right at the top of the screen here. And we're gonna remove the clips. There's some clips on there that you gotta remove, and they come out. Then next, there's the hydraulic lines themselves. They come out. And we got a rebuild kit for it. So that's how we're gonna do that. So for these clips here, we're just going to hold our thumb on it and slide them off with a flat screwdriver. Now, I'm not going to be able to film doing this one down here. I'm going to try to see if I can. Yeah, there's no way I can film it for you, so I'm just going to do it. But yeah, you got to get those little clips off. So, the kit that I got, or the kit that the customer brought in, had these things on the pump already. The pump came with two brass spares to plug the holes. The pump came pre-primed already. The new pump has hydraulic fluid in it, and it came with O-rings to hold the hydraulic fluid in. So I don't know how old this pump is, how long it's been sitting, but it came with new O-rings in the bag. So what I did is I installed new O-rings on the line already, right there. It goes right there on the line. And so what I did is I removed the old O-rings, quote-unquote old O-rings, out of here, you know, because I don't know how long this pump's been sitting. And they got new dry ones, because O-rings expand and soften over time with oils. So I just went ahead and took them out, even though they're probably good, and replaced them. So I did one of them. So how these things work is there's a spring clip that you can see right here. Spring slidey clip, and it slides in and holds this piece down as soon as you plug it in with the O-ring. So you plug this in into here with the O-ring, and then you use the spring clip that you see underneath this. It's underneath there, this piece. and it goes right in there, just like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the other one. So you just go in here, you go in here, slide it in, and then use your needle nose pliers to press it the rest of the way in, just like that. Okay, next we're going to install the arm and bracket assembly to back to the pump. So we're gonna have to slide the pump in there, install the pin and lock washer, and we're gonna have to install the pin in here, in this hole, with the lock washer on top. It's gonna suck, but it goes in that way. All right, so I got the back pin installed with the little ring thing. So one thing to note is getting the cylinder itself into this bracket assembly is hard. It's a tight fit. See where this ramp, it steps down and it gets really tight right there. The cylinder's hard to fit. Don't be worried about it. It goes in, you just gotta wiggle it till it goes in. Okay, so I got the pin back in there. As you can see, it's right there, that little lock pin. Slide it up through the bottom hole, get it through those two pieces, and they lock together.